sounds hard and stormy. Oh, look at this boy. Good Irish leather, huh? Tom is a spring shower and tough as a landlord's heart.
Hey, you can't put your feet up here.
Hit the boys a bigger foot.
Please let me know if this is the right way for you, because for me, it's like my camera's tilted on its side to give the, you know, the wide berth kind of a effect, if you will. But I'm just trying to find stuff to, like, yeah. I think I have found something to place underneath my... It's tilted? Like it's in landscape mode? Because it's what I chose. But I don't know if it's... What the frick? Okay. Right now I'm just making a bit of sky, and then I'm gonna make, like, kind of had this envisioned of, like, a, kind of green, maybe, like, rolling hills or something a little bit. Maybe a stream right here, and then adding some shamrocks with two different colored greens. Whoopsie. Yeah, this is kind of like olive green, and this is more like a shamrock green. Carlinda, if you could tell me if it's tilted like landscape or portrait. Portrait being vertical and landscape being horizontal. This or this? Because I can't... Said it would work upon... yeah, and I hope I'm using the right paper for this, because it's from my new one that I got for my birthday, my first multi-purpose sketchbook. This paper is from that, and, anyways, yeah, and I'm using new paints. I'm so excited, so happy about that. Like, you don't even know. Oh gosh. Anyways. Oh, okay. Cool, cheese. Well. So, is it right now? At a decent, like, you can see it? Yay or nay? Yeah, I'm using HAPS to broadcast, and, it's like a new Periscope equivalent, and, so yeah, it's a little bit to get used to. No doubt about it. Yeah, fun fact about me. I think Irish music is my favorite type of music. Or at least one of my favorite types. Of course, I love Christian music, but it's A lot, like Christian music a lot, but it's, whoa. I don't know, it's just, I really like Christian music. Oh, good, good. Thank you. Okay, so now I know that the when it asks to go, if you want to go to landscape or portrait mode, I'll pretty much just keep it on portrait mode all the time because, sheesh. I mean, yeah. Oh, and I'm using brand new palettes. Not this palette. I'm using this palette right now, but I got it in a 4-pack, and oh my freaking word. I'm just so excited about it. Yes, it does. Okay, so I'm gonna play the film again. I like Christian R&B and rap music. Curlinda, I think you'd really like an artist named Toby Mac. TOBYMAC. He, especially a lot of his old stuff is like, oh goodness, is, well, frankly, just freaking awesome. But the gist of it is just, it's just, yeah, he's a, I'm sorry, I'm kind of babbling. He is what I would consider a Christian rapper. Although his older stuff used to be more rap-ish, if that makes any sense, than now. yeah. I think I'm gonna make some. What the heck is it off of there? Must be just a particle of paint or something, I don't know. Anyways, okay. Yeah, so am I. That's why I think you'd like some Toby Mac or some of his older stuff. nasty.
Did you do something to your hair, Mom?
I just thought I'd try a more natural look. Now sit yourself down and I'll put your breakfast on the table.
That bacon I smell?
It is, and I have a pair of hen's eggs frying for each of you.
Bacon and eggs? Isn't that a little heavy on the cholesterol?
It's time you put some meat on your bones. Now sit down, the two of you.
Does Mom sound a wee bit... I just said a wee bit.
I've been thinking about what you said, Kaya, about your heritage. And there's something I have to tell you.
Kate, are you sure this is the right time?
You was trying to hide it, Bobby. It's about me family, Kaya.
Kate, why don't we just go out?
We're Irish.
Why didn't you guys tell me about this before now?
Oh, I wanted to protect you, Kaya. From the way it was when the Irish first came to America. From the jokes. From the dirty jobs nobody else would take. And the signs in the shop window saying, no Irish need apply. I wanted you to be 100% American.
Mom, that Irish immigrant stuff was like over 100 years ago. Wasn't it? I remember when I was a little boy, my mother used to make bacon and eggs.
Sorry, I'm really right-handed, so this looks weird, but...
A lot of margarine on it, isn't it?
Hen's eggs and a rasher of bacon. Potato cakes, bangers, and a black and white pudding.
What's black and white pudding?
Blood sausage and pork sausage. And I packed some cubines and Kilkenny for your lunch.
I'm like, what did she pack for her husband's lunch? You know what I'm saying?
Okay, it's really weird. You know, at first it's like she's trying to hide where her family's from. And now she's cooking all this Irish food, and she's even talking funny. Okay, so what about your dad changing his name? Oh, that really doesn't seem like such a big deal, man. I mean, at least I know I got a heritage. You know, at least I know I'm... Hey, some green.
Have tame.
Yeah. I guess it must be the luck of the Irish.
Ooh.
That was the beginning of the unluckiest day of my life.
Mixing it in the center. Oh, excuse me. Oh, crap. It's pushing together, dang it.
I lost my lunch.
Yeah, and on your pants, too.
Well, I was gonna, buy my lunch, but I lost my money.
Well, you want some chips? Damn it out.
That's never happened to me, Russell. All right, I can't remember losing anything, ever, in my whole life.
Look, it is just bad luck. It happens to everyone. Hey, Kyle, you want my dessert? Chocolate makes me break out.
Yeah. Well, so much for bad luck.
I'm making a special St. Patrick's Day painting. Well, obviously the sky, and I did actually picture the landmass here a bit higher, but I guess this is like pretty good. Then I'm gonna use this brighter shade, what I'm calling Shamrock Green, right here, to paint some shamrocks I don't know if I want to do it like all over the field or just close to the river here, but it's, I don't know, it's coming along. Sorry if I'm not responding right away, but I'm watching Luck of the Irish as well. I just figured that it wasn't probably kosher to broadcast it because, you know, I purchased it on Amazon Prime, but I didn't but I don't, you know, own the rights or anything to it, so obviously, so I can't just willy-nilly just, yeah. I know what oil paints are. I've never worked with them. Yeah, I'm just doing a wee St. Patrick's Day picture, though, and I'm gonna have to touch up the, ooh, it looks pretty already. It might be hard to tell, but it's, like, kind of like a, because I washed this little square of mixed media paper first, it creates a really pretty kind of, like, sky kind of effect. But then I also, you know, just brushed kind of down, like, scooped color with my brush. One second. With a brush and just kind of scooched downward. Like this. Oops. But that must have been embarrassing.
Semi-final state tournament. You win tonight, you make history. The first time this school has ever had a basketball team make it to the championship game. All right, loosen up. No running on game. Make sure everybody stays sharp. Whatever you want to make 10 foul shots before you go home. That's make them, not take them. Russell,
make them, take them.
Any day now? Let me try, Barbara. Relax. Let it drop.
Oops. You're right.
How many have left? 10. You haven't made any yet? Man, never seen you go ice cold like this. Yeah, that's because I've never been ice cold.
Oh, by the way, this is supposed to be, like, Ireland, so not, and I've never been there, but just from pictures, I guess. But, yeah, this is just kind of something that just spur of the moment, it just kind of came to mind, and I don't know, like, I might draw or paint little itty-bitty stones in the little river creek thing here. I don't know.
Look at the Irish. I wonder why she's watching this.
See that, Kim?
You're gonna have to find a Derby or Gil. First, I gotta go to bed though.
Yeah. I almost thought about asking your permission. Look at you. What are you doing there? Painting an Irish theme.
Irish theme.
Yeah.
I see the green there.
Yeah. Two different greens.
Russell told me. Mm.
So what are you
going to
do for Heritage Day?
I saw
some Irish dancing.
Lose my
there.
Temper.
What?
We're going to have a step dance between now and Heritage Day.
I've heard that. Irish are hot.
Yeah.
Irish are hot-headed.
Well, everything's easy for you, isn't it? What's wrong with you? Why, are you mad about something? I've known you for a long time, Kyle. You're a nice guy and all that, but you'd be a better person if everything hadn't always been so easy for you.
About that?
Look at basketball. The last game, you guys were outplayed, but you won anyways because you got lucky. The state championship isn't supposed to be something you just luck into.
Look, just because you know everything does not mean you know anything about basketball.
That wasn't luck. That was practice. You know, hard work.
What do you mean practice? You don't even play basketball. It was the perfect ending for the worst day of my life.
Sorry. And you just wet this part above where you're actually painting, and you just drag down or drag sideways, and then you can just move it around. Unless you need to get your brushy brush wet. So funny, I've seen this film so many times that I can literally just look through my peripheral vision, forward peripheral vision, and just watch it, because I just know it almost at the back of my hand. What situation? What situation? Heard from Worship. Oh, Worship Word Art? No. Yeah, well, I'm not really like. Gonna. I don't know. Comment on that. This is not really what this scope's about. This broadcast is about. My bad. Actually, I'm gonna change my water cup. Pink cup. I will be right back.
time back. Treat them okay. I will use my small brush.
Half the time I miss the ring complete. Everyone has an off night, Kyle. I never did before. The important thing is your team won. You're going to the final. Yeah, thanks to Dre. You played a great game, especially after Coach took me out.
You don't need to be playing basketball. You should be hurling.
Oh, I'm not sick. I just played lousy. Are you sure you're feeling all right?
I might drink a bit of a warm Bonnie Clabber before I go to bed.
He's a lot shorter.
Nothing like a peat fire to put the taste of air in your breakfast.
He's literally using one of those air.
My dad's gonna eat on Wednesday night.
I can't think of it.
Hey, you look shorter. I think maybe I'm having the growth spurt. No, I'm just, packing a little weight. My mom saw this Irish. We had spuds again. Hey, maybe that's why they blocked so many of my shots last night. I wasn't getting that vertical jump.
You're moving okay, like you always do.
So you think everybody's getting ticked because I played so lousy?
Look, they're not going to turn on you over one game. Besides, we're still going to the finals.
Oh,
there's Drake.
Well, we did play a great game.
Since you feel like talking, why did you tell us what three kinds of metal are attracted by a magnet?
Iron and,
anyone? Russell.
Iron, cobalt, nickel.
Very good. Iron, cobalt, and nickel. Now, take your magnet and one of the metal objects in front of you. If that object is attracted to the magnet, then it must contain either iron, cobalt, or nickel. What the
thought you said that was solid gold.
It is.
Magnums don't lie, man.
This is different. This isn't my lucky coin.
Oh, ooh, it looks so pretty. I'm watching Luck of the Irish, which is one of my favorite St. Patrick's Day films that I like to watch historically on St. Patrick's Day. My parents had their church small group tonight. So we couldn't watch Darby O'Gill and the Little People on DVD together. Plus, we need to actually kind of find it. I mean, I think we put it back. I or my dad put it back where we decided to put it last time, which is in the cupboard underneath our TV. But, you never... Sometimes you just never know. Anyways. Yeah, but I'm watching Luck of the Irish. It's a Disney Channel... A really old Disney Channel film. And it kind of dates me. If you would, if you ever decide to look it up, it's fairly old. It's like early 2000s. About, you know. So, yeah. Oh man, this is coming along beautifully. Dish. See, the lovely thing about watercolor is like you can just kind of just rub around and just kind of move it to where you want it to be. With acrylic paint, you can do that, but it's if you don't do it immediately, it's within. Oh goodness. I think about. In 30 seconds of making the brush stroke, it's just gonna stay where it is. So that's why I'm kind of, I don't know, taking the liberty of. I've been going to different church since I was 19, I think. I think it's 19. I know that I met the prior youth pastor / young adult pastor at a retreat in 2010. Of the church I'm at now, of course, it's not, he's not there anymore, because he planted a church in Atlanta, Georgia, the one that I was telling you about, referring to you, Carlinda, actually, in Atlanta, Georgia, but, sorry, when I paint, I like to use, listen to music, or watch something, watch a video or something. So I think I might just not pay no attention to comments, but just like less. And people who are watching on YouTube have to know that on when I'm live streaming through a platform called Haps, which is what I'm using right now, and I'm probably going to use in the future, after Periscope dies, sadly, after March 31st, you can find me probably just on Haps @ Lorena, Seer, as in S-E-E-R, Aspie, A-S-P-I-E, and I don't really like to state what it sounds like, because, the pronunciation breakdown of it because it sounds really nasty of what Aspie, you know, the combination words are. So I would just encourage you to, like, if you're curious, to just look that up. If you're watching on YouTube or Instagram or Twitter or something, because right now I'm not really in the a literal position to just give to do a search on my laptop because it's not open right now. Oh dear. Good lord, I love this color green. Oh my goodness gracious. The reason I'm redoing my website with a second and newest Wix account is because I made my entire website be or art website. Now I'm gonna just kind of combine three in one, but it just had so much color in it that it looked kind of like, I don't know, a kid's website, you know, like really colorful, but it just not very professional looking though. So once I chose a new email, set up a new email recently, a couple months ago, I just decided that I was just gonna redo everything, redo all my websites and stuff. But I think my flow page link is still in my Periscope bio though. And you can, on there, one of the first things on the list, on the flow page list thing is my art portfolio made by Wix or via Wix and DeviantArt, but the DeviantArt art isn't actually showing up right now, which is really annoying. So I made a link to take viewers, take viewers directly to my DeviantArt profile anyways. Yes, Carlinda, they do believe, people at the Square, Foursquare Church in Atlanta, I believe, does believe in what you believe, and I believe, sorry to be redundant, but, has a diverse, racially diverse, congregation, a lot like my church does. My you know, it was almost a culture shock to attend MC4 full time because most people that were in my youth group there, called the Young, were mainly white or Asian or something. So it's like mostly you know, white kind of, I don't know, diversity, just kind of one-sided or something. Oh, that's awesome. That's awesome, Carlinda. One of the folks who may be watching, who might be watching on YouTube, I'm just responding to someone via Haps. Those who are watching on YouTube, I will be better. I will do my utmost best to be better at at reading your separate comments. In the comment section of these videos later. Lately, I've been kind of terrible at it. I will be right back. Yeah, that's awesome, Carolina. Yeah, for sure. I'm back. Sorry about that. That's awesome, Carlinda. Although, you know, when it really comes down to it, it shouldn't really matter whether you join a kind of like a normal-sized church or a mega church, because, I mean, really, we're all children of God, those who believe in Jesus and everything, you know. But that's really cool. I'm glad that you hopefully found a church that works for you. It's funny, like, my friend Carly told me on my birthday, so, like, 10 days ago, approximately, in a phone call, that she believes my current church to be liberal, but I've only seen maybe some, like, what's it, like, individual people to kind of come across as having liberal beliefs and displaying them, and very, very rarely. I mean, yes, my senior pastor, I mean, you know, God bless him, but he did a racial reconciliation sermon series, like, oh, I want to say, like, 4 or 5, maybe 6 years ago. I think it was about 4 years ago, maybe, yeah. And it's not like, that's not, that kind of thing's not important. It is important, but to, I don't know. I think that it was born out of a place where my pastor genuinely wanted to just help make people be aware and, like, how to, but it was thing about it was, though, that it was kind of like almost like how to talk to Black people or something, like, yeah, but still, you know, bringing in scripture with it. So it wasn't like just this mini political tirade, for want of a better word, really a better word. Of course, I'm just kind of realizing this now, 4 or 5 years after the fact, because I wasn't aware of the whole social justice warrior thing in the church kind of a thing. But it's definitely prevalent now. Unfortunately. So yeah, I'm gonna start the movie back up. Turning into a leprechaun.
leprechaun, Kyle.
Holy crap. Wrong color.
I know it's hard to believe, Kyle. I mean, when I first met your mother,
you're not a leprechaun, too.
No, no. I'm from Cleveland.
We told her, but we wanted you to grow up like a normal American boy. But then when we started out of the squeeze, was
bad. Mom, you're a foot tall.
Oh, it could be worse, believe me.
It's probably just an allergic reaction. Boiled potatoes, something like that. I don't think you have any reason to worry.
Me? You mean I'm a leprechaun too?
And what else would you be? And you with the blood of the Clan O'Reilly rushing about in your veins.
Doesn't mean you can't lead a perfectly normal life, Kyle.
Norm.
Yes, Norm. Dad, look at my hair. And I'm getting short.
You don't look short to me.
Well, of course not.
Yeah, of course not.
How's it look, Dad? Maybe an inch? Or two? 2 inches? Dad, you said there's like an allergic reaction or something. Well?
Just a second.
It's never happened. According to your mother, as long as the O'Reillys have their luck, every member of the clan can pass as a normal human. Ordinary size, all of them. So I'm not really sure how it all works. Well, okay. Okay, maybe that's a strong command. You know, I mean, maybe we're just out of luck.
No, that can't be the problem.
Well, how do you know that? Your lucky coin. That's the luck of the Clan O'Reilly. Mom, I lost my lucky coin.
What's this about losing your coin when it's hanging about your very neck?
Look, it's not mine. It's fake. Somebody must have switched it with a real one.
There's a bit of iron and gold plate on it.
Are you saying somebody stole your coin? You know, I bet it was this really weird old guy really Russell talked to, the Irish. You know, that Seamus McTiernan dancing thing? Yeah, but he was like a pickpocket or something. Wasn't that show at the fairground? Kyle, you know you're not supposed to go there without asking us.
Look, Dad, I just wanted to learn about my heritage.
You can't blame him, Bobby, and be not telling the truth. Now, what is about an old man? Gray in the hair, was he?
Yeah. I mean, he started walking up to us and talking about his shoes. Said he made them himself.
Was it a snake he had on the sole of his shoe?
Yeah, it was.
The miserable old sinner to play such a trick, and you his own grandson.
He was my grandfather? He's your grandfather O'Reilly.
And may his name be cursed for a lawyer. Oh, I'll not let him get away with it if I have to pry the coin out of his thieving fingers myself. And he me on da!
Knew we should have moved as soon as they built that new potato chip bag. We were bound to run into him sometime. You mean Emerald Isles?
Sure. And it's he that owns the whole company, and still can't store oatmeal without burning it. Come on, boys! And we'll shame him with what he's done!
She's like 2 or 3 inches tall and she's trying to reach the doorknob. That's so funny.
I think you should wait in the car. You might attract attention.
That's how it was when we first came to this country. People looking down on you because you're a bit different.
Mom? Am I getting as small as you are?
You're only half leprechaun, Kyle. Maybe days before you're down to this size. Plenty of time for me to make you some wee little gillies for your feet.
Don't worry, Kyle.
Thank you.
We'll get your coin back.
He says he's married to Mr. O'Reilly's daughter.
If my granddad was right, granddad, why don't I ever get to see him? Because I'm not
because I'm not a leprechaun. And they don't believe in mixed marriages. That's why we had to leave Cleveland. We even changed our name so Kate's family couldn't find her.
Well, if you and Mom, you know, like, love each other, why should I marry?
Well, sometimes leprechauns can be small-minded.
Right, so I'll add it. Mr. O'Reilly says he doesn't have a daughter, and for years ago away and not to be bothering him again.
I'm not leaving here until I see Mr. O'Reilly. You okay now? Oh, all right, Kyle. We're not giving up. Just gonna talk a little strategy with your mother, that's all.
Strategy indeed. I love this color blue too. Yeah, he's standing in his twin system too.
Where's his office?
It's in another part of the building. Now, if you follow me, we'll first see how the potatoes are washed.
Thanks, Corinda.
What are you doing here? You're not even a achiever.
I have to talk to Mr. O'Reilly.
Why?
Remember how I told you my coin was stolen? Well, I think he's the one that took it.
He's like a millionaire. Why would he steal your coin?
Because he's my grandfather.
Why would your grandfather steal your coin?
Do you have to do everything? He and my mom don't really get along, and I guess he didn't get back.
I think we have intruders.
Be in trouble. Whoopsie. Yeah, I love it. Oh crap, I have 6% power left. One second. Yeah, I got this blue. This blue color, let me see where to put it. It is called, whoopsie, come on. It is called Grumbacher Academy Cerulean Blue. Hue. Almost rhymes. Yeah, it looks a bit darker. Whoopsie. Looks a bit darker. In the on the label. But this is actually what it looks like when it dries. It's a really, really, really pretty blue. A really, really pretty light blue. Oh my gosh. How pretty. English. And then I got this set of paints, which is amazing, from my aunt and uncle for my birthday on March 8th. It's awesome. Yeah, I got maybe, let's say about 7 of these little, not of this color, although I do love it, but, so 6 or 7, 7 or 8 maybe of these by Grumbacher brand, because my, you know, because of stupid COVID, I guess, my parents were just like, well, screw it, we're just gonna take Lorena to Hobby Lobby. And Hobby Lobby is like one of my favorite stores ever. Yeah, it's very, excuse me, like the faintest, lightest blue. Excuse me. Anyways, so I actually ended up at Hobby Lobby having to call my grandma, to ask her what kind of watercolor paint she uses. The ones where, you know, you put them on a palette like this. And really, this is for mixing, but this is what my grandma does. She puts individual colors in all little divots. A little, I don't know, spaces here. So yeah, so I did it for this one as well. And yeah, I'm only using 2 colors of blue, and I'm sorry, 1 color of blue and 2 colors of green. But I do not have enough power in my phone right now to finish this while broadcasting. So thanks. I don't know if you heard the applesauce comment. my dad's hilarious. Anyways, yes, so my phone is at literally 4%, so I'm gonna have to hop off, but I will do my best to remember to post a picture here and on Instagram of this small little piece. This was gonna be, oh goodness, a paint swath, which is what this is. This is, kind of a paint test swath. And it, lets me know what the paint I'm gonna put on paper, or, yeah, paper, is gonna look like once it's dry. So yeah, oh my gosh, though, I think my forte is scenery watercolor paintings. Oh my gosh. Yeah, I'm gonna try to make some kind of defining line for the little stream. Yeah, anyways. Yeah, see ya next time. And a little quick plug about my testimony thing. I think I might make teeny tiny little notes for it. But I'm not gonna do it live. I feel like the comments would just be overwhelming. not overwhelming like emotional overwhelming, but like overwhelming like just distracting. So I think I'm gonna record it probably on my laptop because it's what has the most storage at the moment of all of my devices, of my two devices. So yeah. Yeah, so then I'm probably gonna broadcast it on Haps, like share my screen again, like I did for the download Periscope content, which is still up, by the way, both on Periscope and my Haps thing. Yeah. So, well, it's 8:59 and 9 o'clock. So I would say adieu, and au revoir, and good night, and God bless.